Hello everyone, welcome to our channel least52.com. So let's talk about our today's tutorial. Generally, the water stored in overhead tank is wasted due to overflow when the tank is full. So this water tank overflow is a common problem which leads to the wastage of water. Though there are many solutions to it, like ball valves which automatically stop the water overflow once the water tanks get full. But being an electronic enthusiast, wouldn't you like an electronic solution for it? So here is a simple and handy project in which we will guide you to make a circuit which will detect the water level. This simple transistor-based water level indicator circuit is very useful to indicate the water levels in a tank. Whenever tanks get filled, we get alerts on particular level. Here we will create four levels, that is low, medium, high and full. We can create alarms for more level. We will add three LEDs to indicate the initial three levels A, B and C, and the buzzer to indicate full level, that is B. When tanks get filled completely, we get beep sound from the buzzer. So let's get started. To make this project, we need four BC547 NPN transistor, three 330 ohm resistor, three LEDs, beat and buzzer, hookup wire, you can use jumper wire also, in the breadboard with 9 volt battery and the snapper. First of all, attach all the transistor BC547 to the breadboard. I will connect them facing towards me. So the first pin will be collector pin and the second pin is base pin, that is the middle pin, and the third pin is emitter. Now attach all the LEDs to the breadboard with their all negative terminal to the negative rail on the breadboard. Now connect all the collector pins of the transistor Q1, Q2, Q3 to the positive leg of LED via 330 ohm resistors. The LED must be in different row. Now connect it with 330 ohm resistor. Connect the transistor Q2 and Q3 similarly. Now connect all the emitter pins of the transistor to the positive rail on the breadboard. Now attach the buzzer on the breadboard. The negative terminal of the buzzer must be on the negative side, that is negative rail on the breadboard, and the positive side of the buzzer must be in the different row for further connections. Now connect the collector pin of the transistor to the positive terminal of the buzzer. Now connect all the jumper wires or the hookup wires to the base pin, that is the middle pin of the transistors. Connect all the base terminal with them. Choose the length of the wires according to the level, that is for A level, this is for B level, and this is for C, and this is for D. Now connect a wire to the positive rail on the breadboard and leave it for further connection. This wire must be lengthier than other four wires. So this is the complete circuit. You can see here we are using NPN transistor as a switch. Initially there is no voltage applied to the base of the transistor Q1, and the transistor is in off state and no current is flowing through collector and the emitter LEDs off. When the water level reaches to point A in the tank, the positive side of the battery gets connected to the base of the transistor Q1 through the water. So when a positive voltage has been applied to the base of the transistor Q1, it gets it into on state and current start flowing from collector to emitter and the green LEDs glow. Now there are also resistors that are R1, R2 and R3, which each of the LEDs to drop the voltage across LEDs, otherwise LED may blow up. Same phenomena happens when the water level reaches to point B. As soon as water level reaches to point B, a positive voltage gets applied to the transistor Q2. It gets on and the current started flowing through a yellow LED and LEDs glow. With same principle, red LED glow when water level reaches to point C, and finally buzzer beeps when water level reaches to the D. Let's do it in action. Before filling the tank, just connect the negative terminal of the battery to the negative rail on the breadboard and the positive terminal of battery to the positive rail on the breadboard. Now start filling the water. When the water level reaches to the point A, the circuit with green LED and the transistor Q1 gets completed and the green LEDs glow. Similarly, when the water level reaches to point B, the circuit with yellow LED and the transistor Q2 gets completed and the yellow LEDs glow. Same goes with point C. And finally, tank gets full at the point D, circuit will buzzer gets completed and the buzzer start beeping. Hope this video will be helpful to you. Subscribe our channel to get more updates about our video. Thank you.